Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Olivia here at the Olivia's Romantic Home, and in today's video I am over the moon excited to share with you 7 DIY Dollar Tree Christmas decor crafts. So this is episode 21 in my huge I Love Christmas series. You guys, I love to share with you all how you can make your home's boutique gorgeous on a teeny tiny budget. Don't forget to catch up on the rest of the I Love Christmas series playlist. I'm gonna link it for you in the description box below. Subscribe to this YouTube channel so you don't miss out on all of my Christmas giveaways. But without further ado, go ahead and plug in those glue guns, get out your glitter and paint, and let's get to crafting. For the first Dollar Tree DIY, I want to share with you guys how to jazz up one of those Dollar Tree ho 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 Santa signs. So we're just going to take a Sharpie marker. This is super easy, you guys, and you're going to draw lines down the front of the little Santa hat. There's even kind of some little grooves you guys can see that you can follow along really easy, and you just got to draw one little line down the center. Now I'm taking some black acrylic paint and this little paintbrush. This is a smaller tip paintbrush. I get all of my paintbrushes at Walmart or Dollar Tree, and we're just going to paint. I just used one coat of acrylic paint, and I'm going to paint in the little lines, and I'm going to go every other one to create that Mackenzie Childs checkerboard look. Now, I will tell you that there is a layer of glitter on this Santa hat, and I didn't do anything to remove the glitter. I just painted right over it. The part of the Santa hat is a bit of a sponge, and it absorbed that acrylic paint just fine, so I didn't have any trouble with it. I just painted right on it, and it just turned out perfectly. I was really surprised. I thought I was gonna have to scrub the glitter off and all that good stuff, but you guys know me, I love a bit of glitter, sparkle, and shine. Now I usually love to drag a bit of white and gold through my Mackenzie Childs checks. I will tell you that the white and gold did not drag through how I usually like it to, so you may just want to skip that step. Now I am taking this gold deco art paint pen. You guys can get these at the craft store, you can order them online. You can skip this step. You can also get a gold paint pen at Dollar Tree, believe it or not. So this is just a little extra added detail step. It does make your work look a little bit nicer, and if you're like me and your hand can kind of wobble around, it does help clean up those lines really nice and neat and give it that detailed finish. But it's up to you. Again, you guys, you could also use a bit of gold paint, but I will tell you that this deco art, it's called Deco Art Premium Paint Pen, it gives a really nice finish. But again, you guys, just go for it, have fun with it, and here is how it turns out. So this is the first DIY. If you guys just want to do the cute little Santa hat, set him out wherever you want. Now here's the second step. If you guys want to go a step further, and here's another DIY. This is what you guys want to do if you want to make him a floating Santa, to add him into a garland, a wreath, or a swag is what we're going to do here. So you're going to flip him over, add a pipe cleaner to the back, and then I just use a Dollar Tree tag and add that on top of the pipe cleaner. Let that dry, and that's going to give you guys a way to attach him onto a garland, a wreath, whatever you guys want. Okay, so here's how I'm gonna make this swag. This is kind of unconventional, and I'm really hoping it works out. It actually did end up working out. I'm gonna take 2 Dollar Tree candy canes, layer them on top of each other, and then just take these little twist ties, they're the little pipe cleaners, and I'm gonna pipe cleaner the 2 candy canes together. Now, if you guys want to run to Hobby Lobby and grab a beautiful swag, or take 2 garland pieces and tie them together, that will work great. I didn't have those on hand. I'm really forcing myself to use what I already have. I have a plethora of Christmas stuff that I want to use. I don't wanna go out and spend more money, so comment if you're there with me. I'm taking these extra greenery pieces. They're really pretty pieces of greenery, but they're kind of odds and ends. I'm gonna use them to cover my pieces of candy cane. I bought too many of these candy cane wreath forms at Dollar Tree is where I got them. So I want to repurpose and reuse them. So I'm gonna take and just add the garland onto here. Now I have this garland from Dollar Tree. So I'm just gonna take the Dollar Tree garland and wrap them around these extra pieces of greenery to secure them on here.
You could also use a pipe cleaner or some wire. However you guys want to get that greenery on there, attach it, baby. Whatever you guys want to use. I thought this garland would work perfectly because it's going to attach it and it's also going to be to where you guys can't see it. So I'm covering the candy cane. I'm creating this swag effect because that ho 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 sign is kind of like, you know, it's going to kind of drop down, and then I'm going to want to add a bow to the top and the base, and I think it's going to be so adorable. I actually saw something similar to this online, and so I'm super excited to recreate it. The little creation that I saw online was like $140, but we're going to do this on a budget. So just continue to add your greenery, and again, don't panic if you guys don't have this. That's fine. You guys can create a little swag. Just take two pieces of garland, wire them together, use a wreath form, whatever you guys have on hand. Just get creative and go for it. Now the next step is for me to attach my little Santa and then kind of fluffy out my garland just a bit. Once he's securely on there, then I can begin to make my bow. So I'm going to set this part aside. I'm going to get out my Easy Bow Maker. These are amazing. You can buy them on Deco Exchange. You can also buy them at Michael's. Use your coupon. I bought mine on Amazon. It was a little bit more expensive. I suggest Deco Exchange. The next thing you want to do is find your ribbon. I'm using this ribbon. You can find this at Hobby Lobby or Michael's. Use your coupon. I'm going to add this to the base of my bow. This is going to be about 8 inches on either side. Then I'm going to add this beautiful Harlequin ribbon. This is from Amazon, but I know they have this cheaper at Hobby Lobby. I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. So I'm going to go 7 inches if you have the Easy Bow Maker on either side. So 8 inches for the first loop and then 7 inches for the second loop. In my home, I'm doing a candy cane theme on my big Christmas tree. I do have some Mackenzie Childs pieces and also some hand-painted Mackenzie Childs dupes that I have done. So I really want to incorporate some candy cane and then also some black and white. The next ribbon I'm using is just some plain red satin ribbon. I got this on clearance last year at Michael's, and I'm going to go a little bit smaller, closer to about 1/6 inch on either side for this loop on my ribbon. Again, dig into your craft stash. You use what you guys have. I'm then going to dovetail all my ends, which means I'm going to cut a little triangle in an upwards direction. I am going to dig out my Mackenzie Childs ribbon. I got this on the barn sale, which is a great deal. You guys can also use a Mackenzie Childs ribbon dupe. They have that on Amazon, or you can just grab the dupe from Hobby Lobby. I'm going to dovetail my ends by cutting that cute little triangle in an upwards direction, and I did get that even smaller with a 5-inch loop there. I'm then going to pull this up and then pinch it in the center, and then add my pipe cleaner to the center. The pipe cleaner is going to give me a spot where I can attach my pretty bow to my little garland swag. You guys could do this also in a wreath form. Whatever suits your fancy, go for it. So once I have my pipe cleaner attached, I'll want to really fluffy out my bow. I like to give it a little bit of a fluff before I attach it, and then once I have it attached, I even fluff it some more. The other thing I want you guys to remember is always try to look for ribbon that is wired. I did make two of these bows, one for the top and then one for the base. I attached a black and white ribbon, these, or a black and white ornament. You'll find those at Walmart, these black and white jumbo ornaments, and then a couple of little red and white ornaments. Those are both from Dollar Tree. And then there you have it. You guys have this super amazing, adorable swag. The other thing I did add in too were just a couple of little poinsettia picks from Walmart. So you guys have fun creating a super fun, adorable little swag. Go for it. Get creative and just have fun. The The other thing that I wanted to let you all know that I added into this wreath were my little handmade DIY ornament lollipops. We made those out of some ribbon rolls. If you guys can see at the base, you just take a ribbon roll, you paint them white, and then you add some little Dollar Tree red stripe ribbon to those. So that's a fun little DIY that's super easy to make as well. For the next Dollar Tree DIY, I want to share with you guys a super fun idea for how to repurpose some of these Dollar Tree jumbo ornaments. So you're just going to take the jumbo ornament and you want to gently remove the top. The top is kind of like a galvanized metal. Be careful because the top is sharp. I have cut myself before on this, so definitely be careful on that step. The next thing I want to do is spray paint the other side of it white. You could also chalk paint it as well. The next thing I want to do is I want to add stripes to this and a checkerboard pattern. So you guys could actually do stripes on this if you wanted to, or you could go a little bit further and go for a Mackenzie Childs checkerboard pattern. I wanted to share that with you guys because we have been doing so many Mackenzie Childs dupes, and I realized that I haven't shared with you guys like a jumbo Mackenzie Childs ornament. So I feel like I've kind of dropped the ball or dropped the ornament for you guys. So we cannot have that. So we're gonna go ahead and do a jumbo one here. So I'm taking this large ruler and I just drew stripes on either side, and then we're gonna begin our painting. Now I'm gonna take just some black acrylic paint, and I just use regular acrylic paint. This is by the Arteza brand. I ordered it on Amazon. You guys can also get acrylic paint at your local craft store. You can order it on Amazon, or you can even get some at Dollar Tree. The Dollar Tree craft paint isn't quite as high quality, so it just really depends on where you want your investment to be, how much you want to spend, and if you're just a beginner or if you're a little bit more advanced. I also get my paint brushes at Walmart generally, and I also pick up backup paint brushes at Dollar Tree. So the next thing I want to do is just begin to paint my checkerboard squares. I do like to kind of pull my brush down, and then as I get towards the bottom, kind of pull my brush across the bottom. And I have been painting these checks for a while. I remember when I first started painting them, I was so scared to paint the checks. And I'm going to tell you guys something right now. This is a $1 sign. So if you mess up, you guys just paint over it with some white. It's not a big deal. And if you completely mess up, you can just start over, you know, repaint your board white, and it's not the end of the world. So give yourself some grace, take a deep breath, and trust me, my lines are fairly wobbly as well. So just have fun and go for it. The next thing I like to do is to take a little bit of white and gold. Now this is an extra step. You don't necessarily have to do this, but if you look at the Mackenzie Childs designs, they usually have a little bit of white and gold kind of pulled through their black. So you can take your brush and kind of pull some white and gold through your black. And that gives it kind of that hand-painted look, because really if you study their designs, they're not a perfect black and white check. They're a little bit wobbly. They really look very hand-painted, and it's kind of the charm that I love about it. It also gives me confidence because when I look at their designs, you can tell that it's hand-painted. It's not perfect at all. So that should give you guys some confidence to try this and for it not to be actually be perfect, because theirs are definitely not perfect. You can tell that there's a human that is painting this. So take a deep breath, have fun, and go for it. You also might want to paint some into your white lines. Now, I used to not paint into my white lines because, I don't know, it just kind of drove me a little bit crazy, and I did even have to go back after this all dried and paint more white onto my white lines. But take a deep breath, have fun, go for it, and give yourself some grace. It's just, I really love the process of this. Something about painting these checkerboards is very therapeutic. Comment and let me know if you guys have fun with this and what you guys think about painting the checks. Is it therapeutic for you guys as well? The next step for this DIY, if you guys want to take this step, is to go in with a gold paint pen and paint a little bit on the outside of your checks. Now, normally I do not do this with my checks, but for this, because it's a holiday ornament, I thought it might be fun to give it a little pizzazz and jazzy razzle dazzle. Boy, that's a really extra word. Jazzy razzle dazzle. That should be on a t-shirt somewhere, or I don't know. That's a pretty extra word. So because this is an extra holiday sparkle and shine, we're going to add some gold to this. So my gold paint pen was giving me a little bit of extra trouble today. Maybe I had been overusing it. Anyway, I did go ahead and paint some of that in and around some of my lines. You can find the gold paint pen at any of your local craft stores. I also painted my galvanized metal with some gold paint as well, and then I just reattached it to the top of my little ornament. So this gives me a really oversized jumbo ornament, and here is how it came out. Now, if I would have decorated my large giant tree, I would have done a bunch of these because I think these would look super cool done on a really large tree. Like maybe you have a 12-foot tree. These would be amazing. I think they would be so cool. They would pop so well. And I'm going to find a way to use these probably in and around my dining room or kitchen. I'm sharing these in my dining room, but I'm not totally for sure if it's going to stay here. I moved it into my kitchen when I was done with this. So for the next Dollar Tree DIY, we're going to do another one of these jumbo ornaments, except for this time I want to do a candy striped one. So again, I'm going to take this jumbo Merry Christmas sign. I'm going to remove that galvanized top. Be very careful again when you're removing it because that galvanized top is metal and it can prick your fingers. I've had that happen, so be careful. I'm going to spray paint it with some flat spray paint, and then I want to do a candy stripe on this one. I've never done this before, so it's a little tricky. I'm going to use this little paint and I'm going to draw a circle in the center, and you can see I have like a little candy stripe ornament over here to kind of reference. So I was kind of trying to look at it to see what the pattern of this would be, but basically you just want to kind of candy stripe some swirls out to the side, and it seemed to me like the candy stripe started like smaller and then grew larger as I went. I will tell you to do a larger candy stripe than I was doing because it was a little bit hard to paint that small at the base. So I hope you guys can tell what I'm talking about, but you can see I'm drawing really small. I also did this in a Sharpie so you guys would be able to see it really well. Sometimes when I draw in pencil, you can't see the tutorial very well. But I will tell you, don't do this in Sharpie if you're going to be painting in red because it's very hard to paint over. Just a little FYI from me to you. Now I'm going in with some red acrylic paint and I'm going to start in the center and then work my way out. And I will tell you guys, when you're painting a swirl design, try to keep your brush a little bit wet with the acrylic paint, and that will help you pull your paint into the swirl. So I'm just painting the red and then skipping and then painting the red. And then I did go back in and accent a little bit deeper with some white paint as I overlaid the red. And here is how it looks so far. Once I'm adding in that white, I really liked it so much better. So I feel like the white definitely helped it out, and it also helped kind of cover up some of my wobbly lines. The other thing I did was I did paint the gold topper on the galvanized part just to give it a little bit of extra pizzazz, and then I reattached it with some hot glue. And here is how it turned out. I thought it looked really whimsical and fun in my dining room area. I think it's going to pair nicely with my little black and white check oversized ornament. I'm not totally for sure how I'm going to display these, if I want to add them into a garland with like a big oversized bow. I think they're just so fun and fabulous and just perfect for an extra special sparkle and shine holiday. For the next Dollar Tree DIY, I decided to go ahead and paint this super adorable little Dollar Tree gingerbread house. I started out by painting the little gold baubles on the front, just gold, and then I actually decided to paint the entire gingerbread house with the furniture polish that comes in a 3-pack at Dollar Tree. So I wasn't for sure how I was gonna go about painting this house because it had so many little details on it, and I knew that I was gonna get frustrated trying to use a paintbrush. But I realized I had little furniture polish markers, and I will tell you that these worked out really, really well. So they have a really fine tip to them. Now, the one thing I will tell you is that they do bleed just a little bit. So when you're going around the edge of the different little details of the gingerbread house, you want to maybe leave a little bit of room. And if you guys use these, you'll kind of know what I'm talking about. But otherwise, I thought that they made a really cute little gingerbread kind of color to it, or they almost make it look more of like a wood cabin type feel. But I like that. I think it felt really nice and cozy and fun. And I was able also to get inside the grooves of the windows. Again, I really wanted to paint this, but I knew that I was going to get really frustrated with trying to paint this just because I don't have that great of fine motor skills when it comes to really tiny detail work. And this gingerbread house had like these really fine little detail work with like the wreaths and the trees. And it doesn't seem that small really when you're looking at it on camera, but when you look at it in person, it's intimidating. At least to me it was, especially with like the little light bulbs and whatnot. So anyway, I'm just going through this with the starting out with my base coat. And then I decided to go in with this small paintbrush and begin to trim out the windows. I decided I thought a gingerbread house would be really cute with red. So I'm doing red paint around the windows. And then it looks like to me that there's snow on the windows. So I did go in with some white paint to do the snow with. Now that I have the snow all the way across the top of my little house, I decided to go ahead and remove the topper. I decided I didn't really want to hang this. I'm going to end up probably setting it in my kitchen, and I wanted to add some glitter. Although hindsight is 20/20, I did end up adding some glitter, and the Mod Podge that I used to add the glitter made it bleed a little bit. So I think I'm going to go back over. I'm going to sand off some of the glitter, and I'm going to end up adding, I think, some puffy paint to kind of make my snow stand out. But now I'm just adding in some green paint to make my cute little trees nice and green. But this is so fun, and I really think that you guys could add so many little doodads and goodies to this. You could really dig into your craft stash and have fun getting creative and making just a happy, fun little gingerbread house. And here is how it turned out. I set it in with my little DIY Dollar Tree gingerbread mailbox and then my cute little gingerbread. I actually found this at Hobby Lobby. I did not DIY the gingerbread doll, although if I could do that, I think that I would be really impressed. I did DIY the cute little gnome. My little cute little gnome. Anyway, here is how it looks. I did add glitter, and you can tell that it looks kind of snowy, but it did bleed kind of in and around my trees, which I wasn't crazy about that. But so fun and fabulous, and really this would be a really great craft to do with kiddos. I added a cute little red candy cane bow to the top. Actually, it was like more of like it had candy canes on it, but it just said Christmas on it. So cute and adorable. Okay, so for the next Dollar Tree DIY, I'm taking this flat Rust-Oleum spray paint, and I spray painted these cute little Dollar Tree bells white, and then I decided to make these in kind of that Mackenzie Child fashion. And so I'm just taking a Sharpie and I'm drawing lines down the Sharpie or down the bell, and I'm going to make some Mackenzie Child stripes, and then I'm going to go around the bell to make a checkerboard pattern. Now I will tell you, please use some tape and mark your lines a little bit better than I did. This was towards the end of my DIYs, and I thought I could freehand this a little bit better than I did, and I was a little bit wonky with my lines, and so my stripes got a little bit off towards the end. You can see right there, it got a little bit wonky. So if you guys want perfect lines, you definitely want to use some tape, or you could even cut a strip of paper. This is tricky though. These shapes are definitely tricky. I will tell you that checkerboard pattern is so much easier with a flat surface. I always have a tricky part with checkerboards and round patterns. Comment, let me know if you guys have some good ideas and tips and tricks for me when it comes to these round patterns. Anyway, so we're just going to go ahead and take our black acrylic paint and begin to color in our checkerboards. You're going to go every other one. Have some grace with yourself. You'll have grace with me. Trust me. I just love to craft and have fun with it and share my ideas with you guys. And hopefully you guys can get some ideas. The other thing I want to let you guys know is always when you guys see a craft, take it and make it your own. You guys can always change up the paint color. Use different paint color. Maybe you're decorating with pinks or blues or whatever color you love for your holiday. Change up that paint color. Change up your ribbon colors. Make it your own and get creative. I always encourage you guys to just take it and run with it. You don't necessarily have to do what I'm doing, but do something that suits your fancy. I really feel like crafting and decorating is just so good for your heart and soul. And sometimes it's more about the process than it is the final outcome. Although it is fun and fabulous when you guys have a great little treasure to decorate your home with, or a nice gift for your aunt or your neighbor or your mom or your sister. Or it's fun to get together with friends and family and craft if you're able to do so. Now, once I had all of my stripes painted on, I did go back in with my gold paint pen and outline my little stripes to kind of clean them up just a bit. And then I added a big fluffy bow to the top and a bit of garland. Now, as always, I ask that you guys comment and let me know what was your favorite DIY in this video and which one are you inspired to recreate? I love to hear what you guys are up to. What crafts are you working on? Have you all started decorating for Christmas yet? Oh my goodness. As you guys can tell, I have up some of my Christmas decor. I brought out my Christmas mugs. I have so many Christmas mugs and all of my Christmas decor. You guys, most of it is from the thrift store. I do pick up some goodies here and there. But I do have my living room Christmas tree. I'm really excited about that. And I shared with you guys a tutorial a couple of videos back. You can catch that in my I Love Christmas series. I've also put up all the garland for outside and inside my kitchen, but I haven't decorated it yet because I'm waiting to share it with you guys. So I'm super excited to share that in some upcoming videos, more decor, baking, crafting, cleaning, a little bit here and there. So I love y'all. And I'm so thankful and blessed to have you guys here. It's just a true blessing and honor. I'm wishing you a gorgeous, fabulous, blessed day, and I cannot wait to see and hear what you guys are up to.
So thank you all so much for joining me on another fun and fabulous crafty decor adventure. It is such a true blessing and an honor to have you all here. I truly feel like crafting and decorating is so good for your heart and soul. And so I just want to encourage you all to keep up the good work, crafting and decorating and plugging in your glue guns and just keep putting one foot in front of the other. I'm Olivia at the Olivia's Romantic Home, and I'm a DIY crafty mama. I love to do everything on a budget and just share these fun ideas with you guys. Subscribe subscribe to this YouTube channel. It's totally free. I have a ton of giveaways going on for Christmas, as well as I have Olivia's Romantic Home Facebook page. Pop over there. I post DIYs over there, as well as this fun little free group page for you guys on Facebook. It's a fun little community where you guys can post photos of your home decor and DIY projects, and that's what it's for. It's for everybody to connect and socialize, so pop over there. I also have Olivia's Romantic Home Instagram page. I post DIYs over there, as well as little stories on my Instagram page of my puppy and my family, and sneak peeks at my DIY projects over there. So I just love to craft and decorate and bake and sometimes clean. But I love y'all to the moon and back. I can't wait for the next DIY video. Until then, I want to encourage you guys to be kind to yourselves, be kind to one another, and until then, we'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye. That I love you.